guys, welcome back to my channel. It's great to see you again today. And today's video is going to be my 2017 favorites video. I always say that's so weird. This video is going to be just a compilation of the products I've used the most and I fell the most in love with. They aren't all products that came out in 2017. A few of them are, but some of them aren't, and that's okay. So I actually kind of already filmed this, kind of not. I actually tried to film a makeup tutorial using all of my 2017 favorite makeup products, but somehow it just won't import to my computer. So I'm just gonna talk about them instead of trying to do a tutorial, but this was the tutorial. I mean, I can still do a tutorial if you really want me to. I think it's really pretty and I fell in love with it. It's like purpley and green and it's really, really pretty. But let me stop blabbing and we can get on with the video. So why don't we just start with brushes? I think brushes is a good place to start. A lot of them are dirty. I'm not gonna lie, because I barely ever wash my brushes. So I have 6 brushes, that's not that much. So the first 2 brushes I fell in love with are from Morphe. I have the Morphe M535 brush, and then I have the Morphe M441 brush. These brushes look very, very similar, but they're actually very different. This one, the black one, is just a little bit more fluffier than this one. This one's a little bit more dense. Brush works for everyday looks because you can just use like a quick brown color and just fluff it into the crease and then add some highlight here in a corner and you'll be good to go. And then this one is a little bit better for packing on a little bit more color lower into the crease. I really like this one too because you can also use this to like pack on shadow to the outside and then blend it into the crease. The next brush I have is from e.l.f. I don't even know what it's called. It's just like a smudger brush. I think it was like $1 from e.l.f., but I really like it because it's really dense and it works great for packing on color to the lower lash line, and I really like this brush. And then the last 3 brushes are from Luxie. The first one is a face brush, and it's the Luxie 660 Precision Foundation Brush. I use this brush every single day. Every single day for putting on powder for setting my under eyes. I love it. I literally love this brush to pieces. I got all my Luxie brushes in my Ipsy bags. This one is the Luxie 207 Medium Angled Shading Brush. I actually use this today to pack on color to the outside and the inside part of my eye. This brush is absolutely great for packing on color. Like, it's dense but not too dense, so you can also blend it, but then you can also like pack on color and then blend it out. And then this last one is also a Luxie brush. It's the Luxie 239 Precision Shader Brush. I used this brush to pack on the green color into the center of my eyes. I honestly have never found a brush that packs on that much color. Like, a lot of my brushes that I have that are somewhat like this, they do not pack on the color intense enough for me. And this one really does, and I really, really love it. So, I have 2 eyebrow products here that have been my holy grail, and I've been using them for every single day to do my eyebrows. I use them today. The first one is the IT Cosmetics Brow Power Pencil. There's a spoolie on one side, which I love the spoolie, and then there's the actually rig roll-up pencil on the other side. It's in the color Universal Taupe. So it's like a universal brow pencil. My mom thought it sounded really, really cool because you could like build it up the color for like if you're darker or you have darker brows, or you could make it lighter for if you have lighter brows, but I like it a lot. And then my brow powder that I use every single day is my Anastasia Beverly Hills brow powder in the color dark brown. I've mentioned this a lot of times here on my channel. I really, really like it. The colors are really nice. They match my hair color. The undertones are cooler, so it doesn't look too warm. And I really love this. So I have two bronzers. One's a little bit higher end and the other one's more drugstore. The drugstore bronzer is, of course, the butter bronzer. Everyone literally loves this. This is in the color bronzer. I think they have two now. I think they came out with like different shades of this. This is, I think, the darker one. I really, really like this. It smells like coconuts. It smells really good. And I used it on my cheeks today. Oh, my highlight's like popping. But I used it on my cheeks today and I really, really like it. It's super soft. It's really pretty. And you could use it as like a contour and a bronzer. And then my other bronzer is the Hoola Benefit Bronzer. This one's the original one. It is actually a mini size because I got it in a pack of like other Benefit little sample products. But I really, really, really like this. I love the packaging. I didn't think I would really like the packaging of this, but I really like it. This bronzer is really warm toned and it's really pretty. It's just a little bit warmer than the Physicians Formula. So you can tell it's a little bit warmer than the Physicians Formula. So I have three blushes that I literally am obsessed with. The first one is the Tarte blush in the color Feisty. I got this in an Ipsy. And I absolutely freaking love it. I love the color of it. I use it on my cheeks today. And then I have, the next blush is the Model Co blush. I also got this, I got all these blushes at my Ipsy, by the way. Model Co blush in the color Peach Bellini. This is a peachier blush and it has a little bit of shimmer in it. So it gives that natural glow to your face without accentuating your pores. I really, really like it. It's great for like natural makeup days when you want your face a little bit more dewy and fresh, and I love it. And then the last one I have is the Pacifica Coconut Blush. I love these blushes. I love mixing them together. That's my favorite time is to when I mix them together. I use it so much, and there's even a little me on the back of it, and it's not a terrible me. Like, you could definitely use it to apply blush and stuff like that. But I don't think it's that expensive either. These two are the highlights that I love a little, like I've been using the most. One of them I use almost every single day, and then the other one is when I want a little bit more subtle look for more natural days, and then one of them is more intense, which I like an intense highlight almost every single day. So the intense highlight that I use basically every single day is my Jeffree Star Cosmetics Skin Frost in the color Peach Goddess. It's a really big pan. I know you guys have definitely heard about this. I did a review on this and I really liked it, and I'm wearing it today on my cheeks. You cannot deny that it is a blinding highlight and it's really, really pretty. And then I got this Pixi by Petra. It's supposed to be a beauty blush duo in Peach Honey, but it is way too shimmery for a blush, and so I use it for a highlight and I love it as a highlight. I just mix them together, so I'm just gonna swirl it up. I'm gonna apply it to my right here and you can see the shine of that. Look how pretty that is. I love this on more of my natural days. I just take a brush, I mix the two colors together, and it gives me such like a natural flush to the skin without being overly dramatic like my Jeffree Star one. Yeah, I forgot this one. Is the Urban Decay Afterglow 8 Hour Powder Highlight in the color Sin. When I first reviewed this, because I got this in an Ipsy, when I first reviewed this, I was like, this is such a subtle highlight. It is not that subtle at all. It's, now that I've like used it a lot more, it's not very subtle. Like, it's actually very, very shiny, and I literally am in love with this. It's such a pretty like gold champagne-y color, and oh my gosh, look at that shine. That is so pretty. So I have two favorite mascaras that I use. The one I've been using the most is actually the Scandal Eyes Retro Glam Mascara by Rimmel London. I really, really like this. I love the wand on this. It's like an hourglass shape. It reminds me a lot of the Too Faced one, which we'll explain a lot in a second, but I love the wand on it. It's super fluffy. I don't like the spiky wands. I like the more fluffy wands on mascaras because I feel like they catch my lashes a lot more and they just voluminize. Don't think that's a word, but I really, really like this. And then my second favorite mascara is more high-end, and it is the Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara. So why I said it wasn't a surprise is because this wand on this mascara is also an hourglass type shape. The other one's a little bit more hourglassy than this one, but this is my favorite mascara of all time. Scandalize is my favorite drugstore mascara. I haven't tried a lot of the other ones, but for the ones I have tried, that one is my favorite by Rimmel. And then the Too Faced Better Than Sex is my favorite high-end mascara, and I just got a new one of these for Christmas, which is in my Christmas haul, and I'll go ahead and link that video down below if you want to go ahead and watch it. I have two eyeliners that I literally am obsessed with. I have a liquid eyeliner and a pencil eyeliner. So the liquid eyeliner that I love is the Too Faced Sketch Marker You're So Too Faced Felt Tip Eyeliner. It's such like a thin point. It's like flexible without being too flexible. And then the pencil eyeliner is the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide On Eye Pencil in the color Perversion. I got this in my Ipsy, and this pencil is so creamy. It's so black. It's literally beautiful. It stays all day. But the one thing is that if you only apply it to your tight line, it does transfer to your bottom waterline. But I really like it because it does last like all day long. So my favorite setting spray slash primer, mainly setting spray, is the Too Faced Hangover RX 3-in-1 Replenishing. Oh my god, that was violent. It kind of just slipped out of my hand. It's a replenishing primer and setting spray with coconut water, probiotic based ingredients, and skin revivers. It's silicone-free, alcohol-free, and oil-free. You can use it before you do your makeup, and then you can use it to set your makeup. I love it to set my makeup because I feel like it soaks in. It makes the powder soak into my face really nicely, and it makes my skin look so less dry, and I really, really love this stuff. Let's go on to lips, and I have a lot of lip products because who doesn't have a lot of lip products that they literally love? Okay, so I have some liquid lipstick, some lip gloss, some lip creams, and a normal stick lipstick. So let's start with the normal stick lipstick. So my normal stick lipstick, I can't say that. Oh my gosh, that is a tongue twister. Try saying that 5 times fast. It is the Jeffree Star lipstick in the color Celebrity Skin. I think this is literally such a pretty nude. It smells like orange cream, and I was wearing it today, but I forgot to reapply it before the video because I had soup, but that's okay. But I really, really like it, and it's super smooth formula. And then lip glosses. I have this one I talked about so much on my channel. It is the Urban Decay lip gloss in the color Kinky. I literally love this stuff so much. I've used it so much. It's still going though, but I don't think for that much longer. But I really, really love it. It's non-sticky, it's super pigmented, and it feels lightweight on the lips. And then the next lip gloss is the Anastasia Beverly Hills lip gloss in the color Caramel. I love Anastasia Beverly Hills lip glosses. They are honestly super pigmented. They're not sticky, but they do feel a little bit heavy on the lips. You do have to be careful with that. And then more from ABH. I have two liquid lipsticks from them. I really like their liquid lipsticks. They stay for a long time. They do break up when you eat certain foods, I've noticed that, but a lot of liquid lipsticks do that, and I don't mind reapplying a liquid lipstick throughout the day, but if I don't want to have to deal with that, I just won't wear a liquid lipstick. Two colors that I got were the color Stripped and the color Catherine. I mainly got the color Catherine because that is literally my name, and I love red lips, and this color is so gorgeous. I freaking love it. It's more of like a darker toned red. I wore this for Christmas with a bright red sweater, and it's really, really, really pretty. And then the color Stripped is just a nice everyday nude, and it's really, really pretty. And then the last lip product I have is by Bite Beauty. I actually got this, I think, at like a TJ Maxx, like a Ross or something, for like half price, but it is in the color Crayonza. It is a cashmere lip cream. I actually wore this in my What I Got for Christmas haul video, and I'll go, like I said, I'll link it down below. And it's so pretty. It's really, really pigmented. It's super smooth going on the lips, and I love this lip. It's a brighter lip too, but it doesn't seem too bright. Like, it's definitely really bright, but it's not overly bright, you know? So I have three palettes that I've used and I absolutely love. So the first palette that I really, really loved this year, it was the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. I used this palette on my eyes today. I used the purple on the outside corner, I used the green in the center of my eye. I used Georgia and Candied Peach and Puree, and I used Luscious as my highlight. I love this palette. And to top it off, it smells like peaches. I really, really, really love this, and I use it all the time. And then the next palette is, I've had this I think for 2 years, and it's still one of my favorite palettes. I still have not hit pan. Surprisingly, this one's about to go. I'm sensing it. This one's about to hit pan, my virgin color. But these colors over here are not gonna hit pan anytime soon because I barely ever use them. But these colors from, like, I use, this is like my everyday palette that I use if I'm doing something super simple. I'll just use these colors and then pop some on the lid, and it's so pretty. And I use this all the time. It's such an old palette, like, it came out many, many, many years ago, but it's still such a staple in, I feel like, almost everyone's collection. And then the last palette that came out this year, and I'm super proud of this YouTuber, it's another YouTuber's collaboration, but I feel like everyone and their mom and their dog owns this palette. It is the Jaclyn Hill palette by Morphe. It's so gorgeous. I am so proud of Jaclyn. I don't even know her. I watch her videos though, and I'm honestly so proud of her because this is beautiful and everyone loves it, and it's such a hit. And, oh my god, I'm literally in love with this palette, like, immensely. So guys, that is everything that I loved in 2017. That is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and let me know other videos you want me to do. And be sure and subscribe before you leave. Don't do it. Don't leave before you subscribe. But I hope to see you guys on the next video. Bye guys.